How do I boot if all I get is a blue screen? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got recently. How do I stop it from booting up and then immediately going to a blue screen of death? I'm so desperate to keep it, there are so many things on there that I need to have. So, there's a lot to unpack in this question, ranging from the blue screen preventing a normal boot to what sounds like the potential for data loss. There are definitely techniques to deal with the former, and of course I have strong opinions on the latter, as well as some ways to deal with the current situation if the machine can't be made to boot. This caught my attention before I even started thinking about dealing with the blue screen. Quote, "There are so many things on there that I need to have." This tells me something critically important. You are not backing up. If your machine were to just disappear, poof, would that mean you would lose data? If the answer is yes, then you're not backing up. Now, yes, I know, machines don't magically disappear, but hard drives do. I can tell you for certain that hard disks, as just one example, can in fact die catastrophically in an instant without warning, with much the same effect. And sometimes, yeah, that manifests as, you guessed it, a sudden and inexplicable blue screen of death. So, I want you to start backing up. Honestly, someday you will thank me. Now, I'll admit I have never gotten any useful information from the actual blue screen of death, which is being redesigned, as I understand it, into a black screen of death. Great. At least the acronym BSOD doesn't change. Now, I'm sure that the information is useful to someone somewhere, but it's just not useful to me. All it tells me is that the machine won't boot. It got to a portion of the Windows boot process, which I suppose says something, but not really very much. There's typically no getting past it. So, step one is to boot from something else. That might include system recovery media, either created beforehand or as needed on a different working machine. Windows installation media, which you can either have or download as you need it, again, from a different working machine. The rescue or emergency media created by your backup software. A live Linux media that would run the Linux operating system from that media and not your hard disk. Or specialized recovery media like Hiren's Boot CD, PE, and others. Now, the frustrating part is exactly how you boot from these I am unable to tell you because it varies from machine to machine. You may need to change the boot order in your BIOS or UEFI, or you may need to type a key as the boot begins to enter a boot selection screen or something else. Check with your computer's manufacturer for instructions on exactly how to boot from something other than your computer's hard disk. Then what? What happens next depends on so many things. Without knowing more about the machine and its history and whether there are other symptoms, I might proceed as follows. First, I'd probably try a startup repair from either the recovery media or from Windows installation media. It could very well be a simple startup problem. We could get lucky. Now, failing that, and knowing that you don't have a backup, at this point I would come to a complete halt and back up the hard disk completely before proceeding further. You could typically boot from backup software's emergency disk to perform the backup. The additional steps I'm about to talk about could further damage data, and I want you to capture and save what you have before you move on. Also, the act of attempting a backup may give us some more information about what kind of failure we're looking at. So, assuming the backup works, then I would try a repair install of Windows from the Windows installation media. If that doesn't work, then yeah, a complete reinstall of Windows. And if that fails, well, probably looking at a hardware-related issue rather than a simple software fix. Again, there's not a lot to go on here, but at this point, if we seriously suspect a hardware issue, I would take some additional steps. First, if the backup attempt failed above, then depending on the failure, this likely points to a hardware issue, possibly a hardware issue with the disk itself. I would either seek the assistance of a local tech or even a data recovery service if the information you might lose is that precious to you. Honestly, if not, my first step would be to replace the hard drive. If that doesn't resolve it, then again, it's probably technician time or, depending on the age of the machine, replacement time. Now, one thing I would absolutely do regardless of what turns out to be the situation here is I would remove the hard disk from the machine and place it into an external enclosure, USB external enclosure. This will give you the opportunity to run recovery tools on it using a different computer and possibly recover some of the data on it. Even if the earlier backup succeeded and the drive appears to be working, this actually turns out to be a really easy way to gain access to the disk's contents on a different machine. Have I mentioned backing up? Whether you successfully recover your machine and the data on its hard drive or not, I want you to learn from this experience. And if this isn't your experience, I want you to learn from the experience of others. Start backing up. Do not delay. Failures like this happen. And if you're not prepared, so many things on there that I need to have could easily become so many things on there that I've lost forever. Bottom line, when faced with a blue screen you can't get past, the only real alternative is to try to boot from something else to attempt to repair or recover. If you can't repair or recover, then you may well want to extract the hard disk containing your data to see if you could recover it using a completely different system. But please, in case I haven't been clear, start backing up. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/186121. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.